Hello, everyone. This is the MGTOW Cowboy. Greetings and salutations. This evening, I want to give you guys a little talk about some hopes and dreams I have and some fears and concerns. I don't know what I want to call this yet. I'll probably call this video, I Got a New Job, because I got a new job. So, to start, first the good news. I landed a new job basically a week ago. I went for a job interview, dressed up real nice, got up real early, and I went to an interview. I thought the interview would last, I don't know, how like most interviews last, you know, maybe half an hour, 45 minutes. Not at all. This interview ended up lasting like 9 hours. No joke. Because it wasn't really an interview, or it was, but they hired me on the spot, and then they started training me. And I didn't expect that. I expected, you know, like most interviews, they'll interview you for like half an hour and then they shake your hand and then you go home and they say, you know, we'll call you. We'll call you in a day or in 2 days or something. And then you go from there. No, not at all. They hired me on the spot. And in fact, they were even saying, if you want to start, you could start today. Oh, you don't want to start today. You want to start tomorrow? And, you know, I'm just like, no, I don't want to start today. No, of course not. No, I don't want to start tomorrow. No. In fact, you know, I told them I want to have Thanksgiving off. Let's start after Thanksgiving. And then, they decided that they would take that opportunity to do some work on the truck that they have assigned to me. And so, instead of me starting on Friday or the day after Thanksgiving, I'm starting on Monday. And today is the early morning of Sunday. So basically I start tomorrow. Yeah, so I don't know. It's pretty exciting. It's also scary. So you know, I have my A-class CDL. And I guess this video is also going to serve as like a, a couple words of encouragement to any younger MGTOW men, any younger red-pilled gentlemen who maybe, you know, they don't know how they want to make their way in this world. If you don't know what you want to do, maybe think about trying out trucking. Yeah, it's I got my CDL. I got my CDL back in 2017, and within a couple weeks, I got a job. It didn't take me months and months, not at all. In fact, the very first place that I applied to hired me. I no longer work for them, so I can talk about them openly. I worked for a company called Jewel. I worked for a company called Jewel Osco. Jewel Osco is like a large grocery chain here in north central Illinois. I think they have like over 180 locations. They have a couple of locations in southern Wisconsin, a couple of locations in western Indiana. I think they have one location on the eastern border of Iowa, like somewhere in the Quad Cities. So. But the vast majority of them are located in northern Illinois. So it would be like the equivalent of like a Kroger's or Mariano's or a Piggly Wiggly or something like that. And for 3.5 years, almost 4 years, I was driving a 24-foot refrigerated box truck. Now I'm going to be driving a 38-foot straight truck with a sleeper in it. And it's exciting because my first job in trucking was local, and now I'm going to be OTR, or over the road. I have absolutely no experience with over the road, So, you know, and also it's just worth mentioning, this time of year is typically the worst time to start an over the road position. You know, there's just more, I don't want to say hazards, but you know, possible hazards or complications. The sun goes down earlier. You know, there could be like, you know, I don't know, snow and ice. What's that called? Like black ice on the road. You know, typically if you think about like the ideal driving conditions, you think, you know, you want it to be like 75 and sunny, partially cloudy, you know, dry. So it's sunny, you know, and so the winter, what I'm trying to say is the winter is probably the worst time to start a trucking, over the road trucking career. But, you know, the opportunity was afforded to me now, so I'm taking it now. I'll probably just go like really slow for the first week or two, you know, be really careful. But, yeah, the pay is going to be, looks like I'll be making almost double what I was making, which is really good. Another issue is my taxes. This is a 1099 position. My last trucking job was a W-2 where I would just get paid by the hour. So I don't know. We'll see, you know. It's interesting. Other considerations worth talking about. I've been looking online about over the road trucking. And by the way, if anyone listening to this video is an over the road trucker and they have any comments or any concerns, pieces of advice that they can offer up, please feel free. I'm new, brand spanking new to over the road. So, but I've done at this point, I've done copious amounts of research of, well, shouldn't say copious, but I've done a fair amount of watching some videos and reading some literature.
First off, I bought myself, I don't know what it's called. I wanted to buy something called, it emits EMT waves, an ionic, I forget what it's called. It basically, a stovetop to cook food while I'm on the road, because apparently truck stop food can be like really, really bad for your health. It's really expensive, and if you can get into like meal prep, you know, prepping your meals, making like 4 or 5 days meals at a time, it helps you save time and it helps you save money and it helps you save your good health. That's a concern. So I ended up buying it's like a two plate burner. I was looking for a single burner. They didn't have one at the Walmart I went to, but they had a two plate burner for like $30. I bought it. I wanted to get I think it's called an induction stovetop. A new wave is what it's called. I've seen it. I've seen advertisements for it on television, like as seen on TV advertisements. It's called the New Wave Induction Stovetop, where, I don't really understand the science of it. It's called EMT. It emits EMT waves, and it doesn't even get hot. Like the actual stovetop is cool to the touch. You could put your hand on it, but as long as you have cookware that's made out of like any sort of ferrous material. I'm not even sure if it has to be ferrous material. I just remember learning it can't be aluminum. I don't know. I can't remember all the details. But basically, you can cook, and it heats up the plate, or it heats up the pot, or it heats up the pan, as long as the pot or the pan is made out of metal. But the actual stovetop does not get hot because it uses a different technology. It doesn't use convection. Is it convection? Conduction? I can't remember. Whatever. It's not traditional, where it creates heat and then the heat transfers from the surface of the stovetop to the bottom of the pan. Instead, it uses like, again, EMT waves. So it does it like that. Yeah, I was doing a little research on that. Apparently, it's not good to be very, very close to those. You want to stay more than a foot away. And that is a concern in a truck because it's very close quarters. So all this stuff I was learning, but whatever, that doesn't matter. That's a moot point at this point because I ended up not getting that. I ended up getting just a standard two-plate stove burner thing. Yeah. Another thing I ended up getting is I was looking online, and I saw that they have something called a luggable loo. Have you guys ever heard of a luggable loo? When I say loo, I'm referring to like the British colloquial term for a commode or a toilet. Yeah, so apparently it's very, very common for over-the-road truckers to experience times when they absolutely have to use the bathroom. They have to, you know, they have to do their business. Number one or number two. Number one is a little bit easier. Number two is a little bit harder. So apparently there's all sorts of contraptions that people have fixed up. I hear a very common contraption is it's called a luggable loo. So basically it's a toilet seat that is manufactured to fit onto a standard 5-gallon bucket. I was lucky enough a long time ago, a couple years ago, when I was trucking, I was making a delivery, and there was like I guess some people were moving or something, and they left a whole bunch of stuff in the front yard to be either taken for free or to be thrown out. And I found like a three gallon bucket with like a screwable lid. So I'm going to use that. I can, you know, obviously you put like, you know, plastic bags or something. I got a whole bunch of bags that I'm going to put. Basically, I had to jimmy rig a makeshift toilet or crapper or commode because it is one of the biggest complaints of over-the-road truckers. You know, when nature calls, you can be going 60 miles an hour down the highway and you've only got a couple minutes to answer that call. Otherwise, you're going to be looking at some, you're going to be in a sticky situation. So yeah, just some stuff, just some concerns. I went to a number of places. I went to Walmart and some other stores. I bought some new clothes, a couple pairs of pants. So I went to the dollar store, the Segunda. In Spanish, we call it the Segunda. I went to the secondhand store, got some collared shirts that fit me. I got some not some jackets, but like essentially some jacket slash hoodie slash sweatshirt. I don't know what you call it. It's a zip up hoodie sweatshirt contraption thing. You know, we're in the winter, so, and they were on sale. They're like $11 or something. So, yeah, I got some gloves, a whole bunch of stuff. It's scary. My whole lifestyle is about to change. I will be working basically like 70 hours a week. So I haven't been working for the last couple of months. And I, you know, I had some money saved, you know, so I've been living off my savings, kind of enjoying, you know, the last months of summer, kind of being bad, you know, going out, you know, just, you know, getting money, getting hoes, expensive restaurants, clothes, casinos, traveling across state lines, going to restaurants. Just kind of vacationing and enjoying my summer, but that has come to an end. It's time to get back to work. So, yeah, I wanted to give you guys a video here and just talk about something that's weighing heavy on my mind. It's Sunday, and I start my new job tomorrow. I'm sure over the road will present some difficulties, but I'm sure I'll get used to them. Yeah, let's hope and pray I don't, you know, drive off a bridge or something. I don't know. I'm probably just going to go like a little bit slower for the first couple days. Everything's going to be new.
So, yeah, I guess I'll leave it there. You guys, it's great to speak with you. Again, this is the MGTOW Cowboy. If you like my content, please like, please comment, please subscribe, and please share, and I'll leave it there. All right, take care.